how people shared news before there were cell phones and computers, telephones, and even newspapers? Have you ever wondered how people knew when to celebrate the holidays a very long time ago before they had calendars? Here is our story. A long time ago, when all people lived in one place, getting the news was easy. They had announcers who would walk around town, and after shouting the news all morning, everyone knew that something special had happened. But then people started living all over the place. Even the announcers couldn't get the news across. Mostly, people just didn't get the news. But some special events had to be announced, and the arrival of a new year was the most special of all. So a man named Enoch asked God what to do to get the news of the new year around the world. God said to Enoch, "You need a special announcing tool. Go find one." The next day, Enoch returned with two rocks. "Listen to my fine announcing tool," he said. God said to Enoch, "What kind of announcing tool is this to tell the arrival of the new year? Rocks do not make music, they only make noise. The new year is a time of music and singing, not banging and yelling." God frowned at Enoch. Enoch ran off to find a new announcing tool. The next day, Enoch returned with a gong. "Listen to my fine announcing tool, which makes a beautiful sound," he said. God said to Enoch, "What kind of announcing tool is this to tell of the arrival of the new year? The gong does make a beautiful sound, but it is made of iron, and iron is used to make weapons of war. The new year is a time of peace, not war." God frowned at Enoch, who ran off to find a new announcing tool. The next day, Enoch returned with a harp. "Listen to my fine announcing tool, which makes a beautiful sound and is not made of iron." God said to Enoch, "The harp also will not do as an announcing tool for the new year. The harp does indeed make beautiful sounds, and it is not a weapon of war, but the harp is too soft a sound to announce the new year. The new year is a time of loud rejoicing, and a loud announcing tool is needed, a tool that will carry the news of the new year from hilltop to hilltop around the world." God frowned at Enoch. Enoch scurried off to find a new announcing tool. The next day, Enoch arrived with a golden trumpet. "Listen to my fine announcing tool, which makes a beautiful sound, is not made of iron, and is loud enough to carry news from hilltop to hilltop." God said to Enoch, "The golden trumpet is a good announcing tool, but not good enough for the new year. True, the golden horn makes beautiful sounds, is not made of iron, and is loud enough, but the horn is not a natural instrument. It is made by people and not by me. It is hollow, but it is not naturally hollow. It is made hollow by human hands. It makes beautiful sound only after it has been pounded and shaped by human hands. The new year is a time to celebrate what God created, not what people created. The new year is for all creatures, the animals and people as well. By something to celebrate the new year, which is for all my creatures. God frowned at Enoch, who scurried off to find a new announcing tool. The next day, Enoch was a little late in coming, but he finally arrived a little out of breath. I am embarrassed to present my new announcing tool. It is only a ram's horn, a shofar, not nearly as beautiful as the golden trumpet, or as sweet and delicate as the harp. But it does make fine sounds, and is not a weapon of war, and is loud enough to get the news from hilltop to hilltop. I have done nothing to this shofar. It is naturally hollow, and it comes from one of your creatures. But there is just one thing. All the other instruments were easy to make a sound with. The shofar is impossible to play. I blow and blow, and then a toot comes out, and then nothing, and then maybe another toot. I wish it were easier. God smiled the biggest smile at Enoch, and then taught him how to blow the shofar for the big celebration of the new year, which was soon to begin.